So today, before beginning, if you like this kind of content, what should they do again?
Hit that bell for notifications. Subscribe. Check out my car. It's so cool.
It's so cool. What's it called?
The Kids of the Year Assemble. It's all about me.
It's all about you. What'll it do if you pick it up?
Make you have amazing dreams.
Make you have amazing dreams. Wow. And what about the shop here? These things right here. What will these make you do?
Make you have amazing dreams.
Whoa, man. You got to sign me up for that. All right. More on that at the end of the video. Victims by proxy. Oh, bad dreams because you read terrible things on the internet. Ah, some of the stuff that you see out there in internet land. Ah, they're interesting. Really, really interesting. So, hey there. Today, we are returning to that wonderful world of internet culture where everyone gets to have a victim card. And, well, you can't spell victim without V-I-C, right? So, why not aim it at Vic Mignogna? This is a crossover edition, too. We're talking about, of course, the internet culture aspect, but we're talking about the ties to the anime community. It's brought up in this. And, of course, we're talking about voice actors, because these days, if you're talking about voice actors, you're probably not talking about what they worked on, but rather what kind of accusations have been thrown out. Now, why is this important in any way, shape, or form? Well, because an interesting thing happened not too long ago. Let me show you the after effect first, where you see it right here. And when you look in, you'll notice prettyuglylittleliars.net. So what have they been added to here? Oh, factual background of a case. That's right. This is a filing by Monica Rial and Ron Toy saying that, hey, if you go out there on the internet and you look up certain sites, you're going to find information that, well, it really, really signifies what's been going on. They're going to give you a factual basis, a narrative wherein you can look at it and say, oh my God, look at all of this terrible stuff this guy has done. So, when you look at that, you expect something to be put together. Now, I would encourage people to go in and look at the thread that's attached anyway. I've done a video on that. That is pretty telling about what you're going to find on that site. From, you know, them going in and really cherry-picking exactly what kind of things they want to throw out, and then throwing out some pretty interesting statements that, yeah, I mean, if you threw these at other people, you would expect to get called out, but hey, there's certain people out there that you could throw under the bus these days. Now, this is a newest statement, but it follows up on a statement that we got not too long ago that I think says a lot, too. So I'm going to read this one to you. I'll stop periodically, but let's check this out. The longer Vic is shielded from justice, the more I personally feel the toll of what trauma his victims must have went through. So, again, we have trauma or victim by proxy. Proxy here. Wow, you filling their drama for them. Isn't that an interesting concept? Man, you must have empathy or, again, a certain card that you like to hold up and say, look at me, I'm in pain. Like, I literally had a dream where Vic assaulted me. It was horrifying. So you can imagine, you know, Vic and, you know, his origin story out there. How he became Freddy Krueger. I'm wondering how that would work out. That might actually make a pretty funny meme, you know, taking a Nightmare 6 and basically setting it up so we have an origin story. But to me, this is proof how his behavior affects everyone in the community. Maybe, I don't know, just maybe when you're looking at the internet, you turn it off. You can turn that stuff off. Or when you're looking at this, maybe you should think about what type of accusations land and what kind of proof there is behind it. But then again, that doesn't matter. Accusation is substantiation these days. And well, that substantiation from accusation impacts the anime community. Therefore, excise. You gotta excise it. But beyond that, look what we get here too. There should be a way I could be able to press charges against Vic for how it affects me, but I assume that would apply to many others as well. Class action suit, maybe. Oh, my Lord. Wow. This kind of stuff. Again, you see it. You see thoughts like this quite a bit from internet PTSD. Oh, my gosh. You know, I had the same damage done to me as a person that's at war. Well, it's the same idea here. There are quote-unquote victims victims out there. I read this narrative, and in dreams, the same thing happens to me. This guy chases me down dark corridors. Oh my gosh, whatever will I do? Well, yeah, it gets better. So, the last couple of days here, I've decided to retain a lawyer of my own to investigate the possibility of recouping damages caused by exposure to Vic's sleazy history, which has caused me demonstrable pain and duress. Are you kidding there? I know it sounds crazy. Yes, it definitely does. I mean, where would that sound crazy, actually? I don't know. I'm going to go out and I'm going to talk to lawyers so I can get somebody to represent the pain and suffering I'm going through. Why? Because I looked at stuff on the internet. I read through articles, and those things, they cost me so much pain. I mean, really, if you're talking about that, then why not take aim at Anime News Network? Why not take aim at Plotligon? I mean, those places. Why not take aim at Pretty Ugly Little Liars? Those are the places hosting these. Those are the places that are putting these up. So why wouldn't they be an impact on the community? Why wouldn't they be the places that you would hire that lawyer and get that class action lawsuit rolling towards? But continuing. So I know it sounds crazy, but if I feel this way, then there must be others who consider themselves victims by proxy. The more voices that speak up, the better odds Vic gets just what he deserves. So here, your victims by proxy, they're speaking up, I suppose. You know, so you have people that aren't even related to this stuff that say, I'm a victim too. Why? Because I read about this. It impacted me. I've had bad dreams and on. So I and others like me need to speak out. I mean, look how insane this acts. It's crazy to read through stuff like this, but it doesn't end. Luckily, many of the attorneys I've contacted offer a free consultation. I wonder if they ever feel that they waste their time too. Oh, you want to come in for a free consultation? You have what going on in your life? Wow, did I really give up an hour for this? All right. Never thought I'd use the phone book in 2019, but there you go. And I have a full schedule of appointments lined up for later this and next week. Most of the folks I've initially spoken to seem really interested to hear my story. Looking forward to sharing it. Please record it. Please record these meetings. Make sure that you post them too, because, oh my goodness, this stuff, it's got to look awesome. I mean, there are people out there that will take up any banner and fly it. You will find lawyers that will sue for anything, but the difference is they're going to take your money. They're going to take your reputation along with it, and they're going to drag it out there because they get paid. I mean, they get paid regardless. If you look like a fool, no problem. Give me my money. You lose, no problem. Give me my money. You make me look like an ambulance chaser, hey, that's exactly what I am. Don't worry. Hey, no problem. Give me my money. Meanwhile, you see stuff like this, and again, this says plenty about people out there that are saying this kind of stuff, but it also might say something about the place that's hosted there. Like maybe the opinions that are thrown out, maybe they have no actual basis, no actual merit. In fact, much like a case that was brought here, maybe all it takes is a little bit of light and clarity to wash it all away. But when I see something like this, I think, wow, are you freaking kidding me? Are you kidding me? This has to be trolling. But unfortunately, you know, if you're looking at these folks, if this is trolling, they are some of the most dedicated trolls in the world. I mean, they have definitely bought into their role and bought into their role and bought into their role going forward to the point that, well, if they're living it, oh man, they should definitely take up comedy, because this kind of comedy gold, it only comes across once in a lifetime. Remember again, like I said with this kind of thing, this site, this entire thread that a lot of this stuff is posted to, yeah, you see it popping up in litigation. And again, think about the foundation for this. So, you know, when you're looking at this Monica and Ron filing, you had that site, which hosts wonderful stuff like that. You have a Tumblr document that disappeared and one that said, hey, most of this stuff is basically fantasy. fanfic. We don't actually go in and check anything. But besides that, we know a lot of this stuff is made up. And then, well, look at the Google document here. Google document with claim after claim. Things like Neil Kaplan saying, hey, why don't you ride on my shoulders? Oh my God, when you rode on my shoulders. Well, I had a certain hashtag moment there. Well, you can guess what that hashtag is. Because something on my neck. I mean, seriously, that is the place that we're at. This is the thing that destroys lives, too. That's the one thing that you need to take from all of this. Funny or not, I mean, when you look at all of this stuff, this, it's been used as ammunition to destroy people's lives. Wow. I wonder what checks this as we go forward, because if this is the face of society moving forward, well, we are in a lot of trouble. But anyhow, you tell me what you think about all of this crazy. Like this kind of content and want amazing dreams? Well, maybe they won't bring it to you, but might want to check that out. The Etsy shop, we have that set up here. Sounds like some people do need amazing dreams. And you can check out all of the prints, limited cards, and more. Also, check out the Case of the Littlest Umbrella. We have that set up. It's been moving along quite well. Well, we need your help to do that. This, it makes a statement, and the statement is we can defy gatekeepers, but also we can go out, we can bring something to folks, and we can circumvent any kind of mechanism that says, you're not allowed here. Let me know what you think about the craziness that we just talked about, too. Amazing dreams indeed. Pro or con, you put out whatever you want there. I just appreciate you showing up. There are many people that think that endeavors, they made them possible. They may make material, but you show up. So while they forget you, well, I want to say thank you. I appreciate you. We'll do this stuff again pretty soon. And wow, there's always something to talk about, it seems. Always something to talk about. Thank you.